Breaking, Geraldo Rivera's life is over. Geraldo Rivera's life of living on the edge of trash, questionable behavior, and his overall pointless existence might come to a screeching halt if this old-school female celebrity starts haggling him in the mainstream media about what he did to her years ago. Bette Midler, another celebrity I could care less about, has some dirty nasty information about Rivera, and if she starts running her yap like a high school drama queen, then Rivera's stank career might be over. Call Rivera whatever you want, he's been in business for ages and he won't hesitate to sink to the bottom of a dumpster if it keeps him on television. It's not shocking that Midler, someone I always found unattractive and only borderline talented, has revived the story about herself getting groped by Rivera and possibly his crew back in the day. This was so long ago that poppers were involved, which are a drug that people sniff to get high for a few minutes, and it made your libido skyrocket. Sure, he's on Fox, but he's a bit of a dope and most people know that. But what most people may not know is the exact details from Boring Bette's story that involve the groping and poppers. Meddling Midler told this story to Barbara Walters in 1991, but the incident allegedly took place in the 1970s. Conservative Tribune reports. During a 1991 interview with Barbara Walters, the singer described a harrowing experience back during the 1970s when Rivera and his crew came to interview her. During the Walters interview, Midler initially demurred when asked to describe the incident, saying she would get in trouble. "Get in a little trouble," Walters insisted. And thus, Midler went on to describe her experience of being drugged and forcibly abused by Rivera and his crew. "Geraldo and his producer came to do an interview with me in the 70s, the early 70s. And this was back when he was very sort of hot," Midler said, referring, for the gutter-minded, to Rivera's career arc and not his physical attributes. "And he and his producer left the crew in the other room. They pushed me into my bathroom, they broke two poppers and pushed them under my nose, and proceeded to grope me," Midler said. "Oh, Barbara. Get in a little bit of trouble, you don't say." If Bette's story checks out and comes back into the limelight, then it's only a matter of time before Geraldo Rivera has to face the music and sing us a tale of his apologies. Many people think this could crush him and cut the cord on his career, but don't forget who Rivera is. This guy will stand in the bottom of a dumpster, drink the juice, and report on how many fleas trafficked the air that day. He doesn't care. He's a grimy fellow who will do anything for a paycheck. I could have sworn I saw him standing next to the bathroom at Taco Bell reporting on whose stomach grumbled the loudest before exploding all the hot sauce someone dumped on a serving of Nachos Supreme. But the story gets better. Rivera is a bigger creep than you might think, and Midler is likely lying as well. Here's where it gets funnier than the old days of the Three Stooges on Sunday mornings. "I didn't offer myself up on the altar of Geraldo Rivera," Midler said sarcastically. He was unseemly. His behavior was unseemly. Midler then joked, and my friend said, "Oh, what a charmer. Of course you slept with him after that." "I'll tell you the truth," Midler added in seriousness. "If I had known that, 20 years later he was going to wind up as a slimy talk show host, I never would have even let him in the room." What? Bette Midler didn't throw herself on Geraldo Rivera? I don't know about that. She claimed he was the hot item back in the 70s, so maybe she wanted a little taste of that success. Now the part about Midler's friend saying that Midler slept with Rivera afterward. Is that true? Then if it is, then there's no sexual harassment. You can't hook up with a guy and then say he harassed you. It's one or the other. If she did not sleep with Rivera, then that's sad. That means Rivera, the big star at the time, had a girl cornered, gave her poppers, and still couldn't seal the deal? But I thought Rivera was a stud back in the 70s? Was it his looks that still prevented women from going all the way? How can Midler be on poppers and still say no? That's hilarious. Let's hope this turns into a battle of two old celebrities. Maybe Lifetime Movie Network can make a movie about it and we can sit back laughing. If Rivera's career is over, then who cares? He and Midler can bicker over it while the rest of us worry about things that matter, Like how much white privilege I have, or if I can say Merry Christmas in a movie theater without getting accosted by liberals. Don't forget to write hash me either if you're sick of hearing about geriatric people bringing up their flirtatious moments from the 70s.